Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make a confetti brush using Illustrator. We are going to make three confetti brushes. The first one is a very simple confetti brush made out of circles that have different sizes. The second one is just as simple, but it's made out of stars and they have different sizes and different rotations. The third one is actually really easy to make, but it's a bit more complex than the other two because it has two shapes and uses three colors. So open Illustrator and let's get started. I'm going to draw the confetti using the ellipse tool. Select the ellipse tool or press L. Make sure you have a fill color and no stroke, and then hold down the shift key while you draw to create a small circle. Switch to the selection tool and open the brushes panel. If you can't see it, just go to Window Brushes or press F5 to open it. So select the confetti, go to the Brushes panel and click on the New Brush button. Select Scatter Brush from the menu and press OK. For now, I'm going to leave the settings as they are and just press OK to save the brush. The new brush now appears in the Brushes panel. Let's delete this dot and select the new brush. Now I'm going to select the Brush tool and draw a path. As you can see, we now have a string of dots. Now, if you want to change this into a confetti brush, select the path, go to the brushes panel and double click on your scatter brush. This will open up the scatter brush options and we are going to change the size, spacing, scatter and rotation to create a confetti brush. Let's rename the brush. I'm going to call it confetti brush. Make sure preview is checked to see the changes. First, I'm going to change the size, so switch it to random, and I'm just going to make some of that smaller. I think 20% is enough. But as you can see now, we have different sizes. The larger ones are the original size, and then we have very small dots. Now I'm going to change the spacing to random. This is the distance on the horizontal axis between the dots, so I am just going to decrease this. And as you can see, if the distance is smaller, we are going to have many dots. If we are going to increase this, we are going to have fewer dots because the space between them is very large. You can play with the values because it depends a lot on how you want the confetti brush to look and how big your dots are. What really makes this brush a confetti brush is the scatter option. So set it to random and change the spacing. Changing it will make the confetti move away from the path. Again, you should experiment with the values. You might want it to be very close to the path or to be scattered on your artboard. Another option we have is the rotation, but because we have circles, I'm going to leave it fixed. If you want to be able to change the colors later, change the colorization method to Hue Shift. Then press OK to save the brush. Click Apply to Strokes to see the changes. And if you want to have different confetti, just make sure the path is selected and then click on the brush. Next, we are going to create a confetti brush using stars. So make sure you have a fill color and no stroke, and then change to the Star tool and draw a small star. Now switch to the Selection tool and drag it to the Brushes panel. Again, click Scatter brush to create your own scatter brush and then click OK to save it. Now let's delete the shape. Make sure the new brush is selected and using the brush tool, draw another path. Just like before, we have now a string of stars, so double click on the star brush in the menu to open the scatter brush options. Let's give it a new name. I'm going to call it star brush and we are going to change everything to random, even the rotation. And just like before, I am going to change the size, the spacing, the scatter to create a confetti effect, and I am also going to change the rotation. So if you have the rotation set to random and change the angles, you can see now that the stars have a different rotation. Again, change the colorization method to Hue Shift and then press OK. Now, if you want, you can click on the star brush again to change the way the stars look on the path. If you want to change the color of the confetti, make sure the path is selected, select the straw color, and then choose another color. You can do the same with the other brush. You can only do this if you have a hue shift selected, but if you don't have it selected, just go back to the brushes menu and change the colorization method. Now I'm going to delete these two paths and I'm going to show you how to create the third brush. I'm going to remove the stroke and add a fill color, and then I'm going to use the star tool to draw a few stars. Now I'm going to switch to the ellipse tool and draw a few circles between the stars. I'm going to switch to the selection tool and rearrange them. I want to have a bit more space between them. Now I'm going to recolor some of the dots. When you are happy with the way they look, select all of them, and if you want, you can also change the opacity. They will look better if they overlap. So you can go to Window Transparency to open the transparency panel and change the opacity to 90%. Now I am going to click the new brush button and select Scatter Brush. This time I won't make many changes to the scatter brush. I'm going to change the size to random and make it a bit small, let's say 80%. I'm also going to change the spacing from 80% to 120% and change the rotation a bit. You might also try changing the scatter, it depends on how your objects are arranged. Then press OK to save the brush. Now I'm going to delete these shapes, switch to the brush tool, and let's test it. I think this looks pretty good. If you don't like the way it looks, you can go back to the scatter brush options and change maybe the spacing or the scatter. Then press OK to save it again. If you apply the confetti brush to your artwork and don't like the way some of these objects look, for example, I don't like that this star overlaps the circle, you can expand the path. So go to Object, Expand Appearance, ungroup it, and ungroup the objects again, and then you can change the way they are arranged. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!